Good morning, students. We'll see the demo program of cube rotation with perspective view. So the program is here. Let me execute the program. I'm running the cube. So we'll see the output. So this is the actual cube with perspective view. Now let us see the program. First, vertices are defined. So the cube is having 8 vertices. Already these are explained in the concept slide. So 8 vertices are defined here. 0th vertex, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. All 8 vertices are defined and colors are assigned. So RGB white, yellow, magenta, cyan, black. So YMC black. We have defined the vertices, we have defined the colors. How the cube will be constructed? By calling this polygon function, vertices array and color array are called here. The cube will be constructed here. Now let us start from the main. The first command, already I have explained all these commands in the basic slide. Now let me give an overview. Glut init is initializing glut file with your C++ file. So these are command line argument. Here glut init display mode is initializing double buffering because we are using depth value here. Front buffer and back buffer will be automatically used by OpenGL. And we are using RGB color model. We are using glut depth. So we are using 3 value to draw the vertex. We are drawing a 3D object. So depth value is initialized. The initial window size is 500 500, these are 500 500, and we are giving a title, experiment number 4 color cube. The title is appearing here. So glut create window is creating the output window, and we have these functions in this program: reshape, display, mouse, keyboard. And because we are using the depth value, we are enabling GL enable GL depth test. Glut main loop, it keeps all the callback functions inside a loop. So till you close your program, it is under a loop. Now we'll see the first function, myReshape. So myReshape will take the current window width and height. So this window is having some width value, height value. So whenever you resizing the window, so there is a new W and new H that is taken in this parameters. So your GL viewport will take the current W and H parameter from the origin. The origin is here from 0, 0. What is the current W and current H? That is taken. GL matrix mode, GL projection. GL projection is a 4 cross 4 matrix. It takes this output in the projected form. So by calling this matrix, this projected output is drawn. So here we are initializing the GL projection matrix. We are multiplying that projection matrix with identical matrix, that is also a 4 cross 4 matrix. Whenever you resize the window, so either you may increase this side or this side, either left right or bottom top will be adjusted. According to that, GL frustum view volume will be created. Already we have seen the view volume is -2 + 2 - 2 + 2 and 2, 20. So that view volume, pyramid view volume is created. Now we are looking from Z direction. According to this value, the ratio will be multiplied either left right or bottom top. So the output will be a smooth output. If you don't give this ratio multiplication, we'll see the output. And in that case, you can give only one GL frustum. It does not make any difference. I like to remind that the previous program we were using GL ortho. Ortho was giving a parallel view. Now here GL frustum is giving a perspective view. And GL matrix mode, again we are converting this matrix to model view matrix to see the output. So later I'll change this value, I'll show you the output. If I don't give model view, what output will come? After reshape function, we'll see the display function now. So here is the display function. GL clear color is setting the background color. I have set the gray color here, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, and one is called alpha color. GL clear, we are clearing color buffer bit as well as depth buffer bit because we are using 3D. We are initializing the identical matrix here. We are setting the view. GLU lookup command is setting a view. So the first three parameters are viewer parameter. I'll minimize. The next three parameters are center of the cube. The last three parameters are up vector. So this is the, this view has been set on z axis. We can see the variable static viewer x, y, z. So the viewer is standing on z, or you say the I coordinate is set on z side. If we are standing on z side, we can look at on y side as well as x, or only on y. So this output is only on y. Then GL rotate we are calling. Out of these three GL rotate, any one rotate will come. You can rotate either on x side or y side or z side depending on your current selection. Then we are calling the color cube. Color cube, six polygons are called. These indexes are passed to the vertices array and color array. The cube will be constructed by combining six polygon. The control will come back here. GL flush will bring the output from frame buffer to your output screen. Glut swap buffer, because we are using double buffering, we are using glut swap buffer here. So it automatically takes values to front buffer and back buffers. After display, we are calling the mouse function. The mouse function is here. It takes four input value, which button and state of the button, the position of XY, that is arrow, current arrow position will be taken in this X and Y. So if you press left button, down means you are pressing down, or you can give up. Whenever you are releasing the button, you are changing the axis value. Here, by pressing left button, we are setting axis equal to 0, means x axis. By pressing middle button, we are setting the axis to y axis. By pressing right button, we are setting axis to z. For every mouse click, we are rotating the cube also. The difference between third and fourth program is, there it was a continuous rotation, but here for every click, 1 degree rotation will happen. Once it reaches 360, we are resetting to 0. We are just adding with minus 360, so it becomes 0. After that, we are having a keyboard function for camera movement. So you can press either small x, small y, small z, capital Z. So along with this axis, either you will move near to the object or you will move away from the object. The keys function takes your key input as well as your mouse arrow's current position, x, y. So this one we are not using. So you don't confuse with this x and this x, both are different. So that's all the code. I have explained the code. Now let us see the output. So this is the actual output of perspective view. By seeing this color array, student can understand that we are seeing RGB white. That is the back face of backside of the cube. So in our third program, we were seeing front side of the cube. Why we are seeing the backside of the cube? Because the view has been initialized from 2 to 20. So the view has been set from plus z, only on plus z, whereas in the previous program it was minus 10 to plus 10. So we were seeing front face, here we are seeing back face. Now let me rotate. I am giving right button, so the cube is rotating about z side. So for every click, 1 degree rotation is happening. Now let me rotate on some other axis, x axis. So I am rotating on x, suddenly the cube is disappeared. It is because we are looking at on only one side, only one axis. Same manner you can give middle, that is on y side. The view is coming like this because we are looking at on only one axis. Now let us see the keyboard function. We'll see the keyboard function. Let me press Z. So as soon as I press Z, you can see it is disappearing. It means the cube, unit cube we are using, size is 111, and the x-axis start from 2 to 20. Now I'll press the same thing. Now I am seeing the backside. Now I am moving away. I am pressing small z. So you can see the keyboard function here. By pressing small z, I am moving away. Now I will give capital Z. I am moving near to the object. Backside, center of the cube. Again we are seeing the cube. Now still same key I will press. So in the axis, the movement is happening on Z. 2 to 20 is continuously changed here. Now 2 to 20. The view from Z side is always very easy. Now we'll see the view on X and Y. So let me press X. So rotation is happening on X side. Now ulta X. That is capital X. This is capital X. Now Y, small y. Rotation about Y. The opposite shift to Y I'll press. So rotation is happening. Now let us change few parameter and we'll see the output. So let me close. If suppose you don't give model view, you don't convert back to the model view, what will be the output? So I'll comment the model view in your my reshape. I'll run the program again. So model view, actually this output is the previous output. I have to build and run. Let me build the program. Build and run. Now the cube is filled in the entire view volume. This output is coming because the object has not converted back to the model view. So still the same cube, same rotation only happening, but the viewpoint has changed. It has to be converted to model view. So now I'll activate the model view. One more example I'll show. This view is showing from Z direction to Y. Let me see on two sides. The viewer is on Z side, will see X and Y. So I'll set the value on X 1. Now we'll see build and run. If you simply run, the previous output only we'll see. So now we can see it. We are seeing two axes. It is diagonal. Earlier it was cube, horizontal. Now same operations are done. So you can rotate on X side, you can rotate on Y side, you can rotate on Z side. So in this case we are setting from Z to the up vector is two side, X and Y side. So the cube size is changed. One more example I'll show. You can change the view volume. So I'll comment the old one. Same command, but it is given with 10. You can give a 10 view volume. So this is up vector value with 10 we are giving. So Z side, let me press. Shift Z I'm pressing. So that's all the output. I request the students to change all the value. So you can test the view of the cube from X side, from Y side, from Z side, or all three, and that is I coordinate. Center coordinate also you can change. You will see the different axis and up vector also. Only X, only Y, only Z, combination of XY, YZ, ZX, or all three. So like that, all the parameters you can check and you can understand the cube rotation in depth. Thank you.